Why do we speak? Because one of the ways you speak the blessing, when God ordained from Jesus himself, he blessed by saying. Priesthood releases people by saying. Are we together? May his favor be upon you and a thousand generation and your family, your children,
their children, their children. May his breath go before you and behind you and beside you, all around you and within you. He is with you, he is with you in the morning, in the evening, in your coming. And your glory, and your weeping, and rejoicing.
Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. We're wrapping up May. June is the last of the first half of the year. And there are things that some of you are yet to see in your life. In the name of Jesus, I call upon the God who has sent us by the power that raised Christ from the dead. I know that there are still a few days to the end of May. My God will surprise you. My God will surprise you. Some of you, hear me. Some of you, literally by this time tomorrow, I stand by Apatatoske. Help that gentleman. By this time tomorrow, may my God surprise you. Number two, in the name of Jesus Christ, I want to pray for direction. Some of you are confused. That is the reason why you are stagnated. When direction comes, speed comes too. In the name of Jesus, in your dreams, in your visions, may God give you clear directions. Clear directions for the next, clear directions for the next season in the name of Jesus Christ. There are some of you, the reason why things are not going well is simply because you have not joined the right chariot. He told Philip, join this chariot. Hallelujah. And he joined that chariot and it became the salvation of the utopian Enoch. I want to pray for you in the name of Jesus. Every strategic relationship that must be introduced to your life for your rising, for your making, between now and the end of June, may my God bring strategic people to your life. Ministry relationships, business relationships, destiny relationships, covenant relationships, receive it in the name of Jesus. Hear me. There are many of you, the situation you are in now, you cannot advocate your liberty. It will take somebody who is already in the palace. You are Joseph. You have the ability to interpret dreams, potential to be a prime minister, but you don't have a chance to defend yourself in front of Pharaoh. But there is a wine presser somewhere. I don't know who is already where, in a place where they can speak for you, and they are not speaking for you because they have forgotten you. I place you in their mind. By the Spirit of the Living God, I place you in their mind. May God cause them to speak for you. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. The Lord is asking me to rebuke the spirit of fear. The Bible says God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of love, power, and of a sound mind. It says to deliver them who through the fear of death have all their lifetime been subject to bondage. There are many of you, you are not sick, but the fear that is on you, you get up in the morning, will an accident happen? You just feel something small in your body and the devil says death. The voice of the enemy, I want to silence it right now. Every voice that is planting fear, in Jesus' name, that voice is hereby silenced forever. Silence forever. Silence forever. I prophesy over you, you shall not die. No untimely death in the name of Jesus. Please hear me. Anybody that is plotting evil against you, whether kidnap or accident or sickness, in the name of Jesus, let the earth open and swallow them. Let the earth open and swallow them. In the name of Jesus Christ. Any charm, any coven, any satanic place, in the name of Jesus, that carries anything that belongs to you, I declare that the power fails instantly. Let me pray for someone who is trusting God for a job. In the name of Jesus, may Ebenezer, the helper of men, surprise you. In the name of Jesus. Every ministry here, every business that is dead or dying, everything in your hand that is dying, you are holding something that is dying, I give it life now. Let it come back to life now. Your business comes back to life. Your body comes back to life. Your ministry comes back to life. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Whatever has taken the glory of the Lord upon your life. For Samson, it was Delilah that took that glory from him. For Gideon, something happened and he, the least person, the least in his father's house, all those idolatry brought them to a place of subjugation. Whatever has taken the glory of God upon your life, you used to be great. You used to be anointed. You used to be favored. Something happened and you just started drying up like a tree. In the name of Jesus, may the restorer restore you tonight. I say it again. May the restorer restore you tonight. May the restorer restore you tonight. Hallelujah. Please hear me. Any door that was once open for good, and whether by mistakes on your part, by not understanding the laws that keep doors open, or by some demonic thing, that door closed. Whether doors of favor, doors of relationship, doors into the heart of great men. I stand and call upon he that has the key of David, the one that openeth and no man shutteth, and shutteth and no man openeth. I speak to that door, Ephata, be open. Be open. Be open. The door to the hearts of kings, be open. The door to your destiny helper's hearts, be open. In the name of Jesus Christ. I've taught you that who hates you does not matter, but truly who likes you matters. Are we together? Let me pray for you. You are not stagnated, but you are not making constructive progress. It will take you 1 year to do something that can be done in 2 months. That is not the will of God. I want to declare acceleration for you. By the power that raised Christ from the dead, some of you, between now and the next 2 months, you will do things you have not done in 5 years. I prophesy you will do things you have not done in 5 years. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. I'm hearing the Lord is saying something to me. I must obey him. The Lord is saying there are families where there are covenants that you and your children will never marry or enjoy marriage or marry and go back to your parents' homes. The Lord is saying I should speak over you. I stand by the privilege of priesthood. Every family that the doors of marriage has been closed, let it be opened now. 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 And in the name of Jesus, for every marriage right now that is epileptic, it looks as if it is crashing. The devil is joining the head of husband and wife and causing trouble. I declare peace to that storm. Peace to that storm. The wisdom to live in peace, let it be released upon you. In the name of Jesus. Koinonia, hear me. In the name of Jesus Christ, I decree and declare, when men say there is a casting down, for you. Let it be that there is a lifting up. Whether you are in Abuja, you are in Lagos, you are in Kano, whether you are in Nigeria, you are in UK, you are in US, regardless the location, from tonight, may the blessing speak on you. May the blessing speak on you. With that blessing, let there be favor. With that blessing, let there be speed. With that blessing, let there be restoration. With that blessing, let there be restoration. I say it again, with that blessing, let there be restoration. In the name of Jesus. Two more prayers. Can I pray for your finances? For as long as I live, I will not only see to it that you are vibrant spiritually and growing in influence. I believe in economic empowerment, where God empowers the right hands. Once God has a heart that loves him, and that you are able to use resources to better your life and to advance the cause of the kingdom, there are no restraints to him making wealth available. Are we together? By this prayer, for some of you, what you will be receiving is wisdom. By this prayer, what some of you will be receiving is access to the right resources. But then in the name of Jesus, I pray. The Bible says, believe. It says, and by a prophet, the Lord God brought Israel out of Egypt, and by a prophet they were preserved. It says, believe the Lord your God, so shall you be established. Believe his prophet, so shall you prosper. I pray for you. God who has shown many help, God who has shown many mercy, picking men from unbelievable pits and raising them to places of honor. I call upon that God to surprise you in your finances. No more dryness in your finances. Personally, corporately, no more dryness. Hear me. If there is any one of you here who is owing, whether as a company, whether as an individual, I don't care. Owing is owing. Anybody who is owing, in the name of Jesus Christ, I place an unction upon you. Come out of that debt now. Come out of that financial situation now, in the name of Jesus Christ. Wave your hands to Jesus and give him praise. Wave your hands to Jesus. Hallelujah. Now, let's